What's up guys, in this tutorial I will show you how to fix the problem when Roshade for Roblox is not working properly on your PC. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. The Roshade not working problem is usually caused by compatibility issues with the Roblox app, an outdated Roshade version, or because of conflicting apps running on your PC. First, make sure that the Roblox client is not running on your PC. Open up your Task Manager by searching for it in your Start menu search. In the Processes section, add all processes that could change your game files or show an overlay while in-game. In my case, that would be Steam, Adobe Applications or CCleaner. You should also make sure that any third-party Roblox apps such as Roshade are not running. When this is done, navigate to roshade.com and download the latest Roshade setup installer to your system. Some people are unable to access the download link. If it's not working for you, then click on the link in our extensive guide to get to the Roshade GitHub page to download the latest version. After downloading the installer, make sure to run the installer to reinstall the shaders you need for Roblox. This can take a minute or two to complete, and a new desktop shortcut will be created during this process. You can then launch Roblox using the new shortcut to see if Roshade is working, with the key bindings you selected to toggle the shaders for Roblox. If the problem persists, then this issue is most likely related to the Roblox client itself. Search for Roblox in your Start menu search and select Open File Location for the Roblox player. Right-click the Roblox shortcut and select Open File Location again. Lastly, right-click the Roblox Player Launcher.exe application to access its properties. On this window, in the Compatibility section, check the Disable Full Screen Optimizations option before applying your changes. Some users were able to get Roshade working again after whitelisting the program in their antivirus application. These steps and more information will be available in my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.